Let's talk about proportional relationships. A proportional relationship between two quantities is one in which the two quantities vary directly with one another. For example, if you are buying apples and each apple you buy is always 50 cents, then the cost of apples varies directly with the number of apples you buy. If you buy one apple, it costs 50 cents. If you buy two apples, it costs $1. If you buy three apples, it costs $1.50, and so on. For each additional apple you buy, the total cost goes up by 50 cents. This is a proportional relationship. Unit rates tell us how many units of a measurement quantity correspond to one unit of another measurement. For example, I could say that I drove 30 miles per hour. This means that I drove 30 miles every 1 hour. This tells us for each change of one in the independent variable, which is time in hours, how much the dependent variable will change. It is helpful to calculate a unit rate when graphing quantities that are proportional. Devin pays $9 for 3 bus tokens. Calculate the unit rate. Graph the relationship between total money spent and number of tokens purchased on the grid below. To find the unit rate, we need to determine how much money Devin pays per token. We can find this by dividing the amount of money spent by the number of tokens they bought. Devin paid $3 for each bus token. Now that we have our unit rate, let's graph this proportional relationship. One token is $3, two tokens are $6, three tokens are $9, four tokens are $12, and so on. Notice that the unit rate is actually telling us the slope of this graph. Recall that slope tells us information about how each change in the independent variable, number of bus tokens, will affect the change in the dependent variable, total cost. The slope is the same thing as the unit rate. Each time the number of bus tokens increases by 1, the total cost increases by 3. The slope is 3 over 1, which is just equal to 3. Amari drove 210 miles in 3.5 hours to see their family. The distance time graph below represents Amari's drive to the food bank. On which trip did Amari have a greater speed? There are many different ways we can solve this problem. Let's start off by calculating the speed that Amari drove to see their family in miles per hour so that we can compare it more easily with the graph. The average speed is calculated by determining the distance traveled divided by the time spent traveling. That means Amari drove at an average speed of 60 miles per hour. Since we know Amari drove at an average speed of 60 miles per 1 hour to see their family, we can determine how far they went after 1 hour when going to the food bank by looking at the graph. We can see that Amari drove 50 miles in 1 hour when they went to the food bank. Notice that the graph that represents Amari's distance and time spent traveling to the food bank is a straight line, which means it is linear and has a constant slope. We can see that for each increase of 1 hour, Amari drives 50 additional miles. That means the slope of the graph is 50. Since a speed of 60 miles per hour is greater than a speed of 50 miles per hour, Amari had a greater speed when they drove to visit their family.